Now you are going to study potential difference and potential. As we know that from our previous lecture, work done is minus Q initial point to final point integration of dot product of E and DL, where DL is the direction of movement. So the potential difference is defined as work done on unit charge in to carry from one point to another point. So it is equal to minus, so work done on unit charge will be W by Q. So it will be potential difference minus E dot DL from initial point to the final point. This is generally represented as VAB if it is carried from point B to point A. So if this is point B, initial point, point A is final point. Then VAB, which is equal to VA minus VB, and is written as minus of initial point to final point E dot DL. So if our initial point is infinity and the potential at infinity is zero, that means BB is zero at B infinity, in that case we can write VAB equal to VA, and that is equal to minus initial point is infinity to the final point, so it is E dot DL, and this particular quantity is defined as potential at point A. So potential at point A is minus infinity to the final point or to the A point, that means A point E dot DL. So we can calculate potential field for any of the charge distribution, and let's start with a point charge and calculate the potential. For a point charge, electric field intensity is given as Q by 4 pi epsilon naught r square ar. So if we have a point charge here having value Q, then the electric field due to that point charge will be given as this, and if it is positive, the electric field direction will be away from that. Now let us say there is two points, one is RA, another one is RB, and the movement is done from RB to RA, then we want to calculate the potential of first potential difference, and then we want to calculate the potential at point A. So for potential difference, VAB will be equal to minus Q from B to A, so it is RB, not minus Q, just minus RB to RA. So RB is the distance from the point charge to the point B. So this is RB, and RA is this. So RB to RA, Q by 4 pi epsilon naught R square AR, which is given as, if you integrate it, 1 by R square integration will be minus 1 by R, RB and RA. So this will become Q by 4 pi epsilon naught minus minus plus. And first we have 1 by RA minus 1 by RB. So the potential difference VAB is Q by 4 pi epsilon naught 1 by RA minus 1 by RB, which shows that this is at higher potential and point B is at lower potential. And now assume that potential of point B VB equal to 0 for RB infinity. So VAB is equal to Q by 4 pi epsilon naught RA. So this potential difference when RB tends to infinity is known as potential. So potential due to a charge Q at any point A will be equal to Q by 4 pi epsilon naught RA. Now let us take the case of a line charge. If you have a line charge, then how to calculate potential or potential difference? See, if I have a line charge which is in the z direction and having line charge density rho l, then electric field at any point can be written as E equal to rho l by 2 pi epsilon naught rho A rho. That means the A rho direction is away from this. Since the line charge is infinitely long, so to calculate potential at any point A, we must know the potential at any other point. Let's say if I know the potential at point B, so this will be rho B and this is rho A. So we can write the same formula for the potential difference, VAB equal to minus initial point. So initial point from B to A we are moving. So B to A will be equal to rho L by 2 pi epsilon naught rho A rho dot. So from B to A movement means we are actually moving from point B to point A in the direction of rho. So this movement is in the direction of rho because this line is infinitely long. That means potential at this point and potential at this point is going to be same, or potential at this point will be same as this point. So electric field also same. Electric field does not depend upon the z direction. That's why this will vary only in arrow direction. So here we can write d rho a rho. So this is the dot product of d rho and a rho. This rho is in the below. So we have VAB equal to minus B point, I am just writing in terms of rho, so rho B, 2 rho A, and then rho L by 2 pi epsilon naught rho d rho. So rho L, 2 pi epsilon naught is constant, take it out, 2 pi epsilon naught is constant. Inside we have d rho by rho, which is equal to ln rho. So ln rho from rho B to rho A. So this is potential difference due to a line charge, and VAB can be written as minus rho L by 2 pi epsilon naught ln rho A by rho B. Here we can see that the rho A in this particular case I have taken as smaller than the rho b. So if rho a is smaller than rho b, then log of this will be negative and we will get a positive quantity. So if rho l, rho a is less than rho b, then VAB is positive. If rho A is greater than rho B, so rho A is greater than rho B means we are measuring the potential in the direction of BA. So potential difference will be negative if the rho L is positive. This condition also you should remember, if the charge density is positive, otherwise it will become negative and positive. So this is our potential difference. We cannot calculate the potential without having a reference potential. So in the case of line charge, since the line charge is infinitely long, we cannot take infinite as a reference for the zero potential. So we must know some point where the potential is zero. So if it is given, we can apply that in finding the potential. So let us take that case and find out the potential. So this is the line charge having potential zero, V equal to zero at a point P, let's say 1, 3 and 5. Now we have to find potential at a point P, which is given as 2, 5 and 7. So first of all, we need to calculate what will be the rho here. So this point is, I have to assume this point as B, because this is the initial position and this is our final position where we are going to find out the potential. So initially, we have to take initial point as B, final point as A, initial potential is zero, and here we have to find the potential. So this is rho B, and rho B can be calculated as x square plus y square under root. So 1 square plus 3 square is root 10. So this is rho B. Then we have rho A. Rho A equal to under root 2 square plus 5 square, which is equal to root 29. So we can use the formula for the potential difference VAB to calculate the potential at point A, or we can say VA potential at point A. So VAB equal to VA minus VB, which is equal to minus rho L by 2 pi epsilon naught ln rho A by rho B. For a given value of rho L, we can put the value of rho L epsilon naught, and then ln rho A by rho B. Rho A is root 29, by rho B is root 10. So for given value of rho L, we can calculate the potential, and VB, which is equal to zero, so we can just write VA as this. So in this video we have learned how to calculate potential difference and potential for point charge and the line charge. Thank you.